have to be honest in the fact that I haven't been honest with you guys. The 350Z has just mysteriously disappeared in the last 2 weeks from the shop. I don't think too many of you guys have actually noticed it, but today we're gonna talk about why and where it's been.
Hey, Cal, look at that front bumper on that Supra.
Wow, look at that. That's a nice front bumper.
Hey, look at this guy.
Weird.
Weird.
Everyone likes these side skirts.
It's not rolled.
I'm not the biggest fan of these side skirts. Is it not rolled?
No.
He's not rolled. Oh, you know what? These are the Redox, I'm guessing, but I think these are the Redox wide body fenders. This is the Redox front bumper, and some people run a wide body and some people don't.
My 350Z has been the most like reliable car I think that I've ever had. Like honestly, it only gave me a problem one time and it was a simple quick fix. And for how hard I drive that car, it's treated me like a king. I don't feel like I've given that car the full attention, the full detail, the full beauty that it's needed, and I decided it was time to change that. I was thinking about wrapping it, and I was thinking about kind of cleaning up some of the interior pieces, and I thought, you know, that would be making a pretty good step in the right direction. But quite honestly, I think LZ had a really big push on me doing this, because a lot of the cars that he slides and just drives, they're beautiful, and I honestly like love that. Hanging around with Rad Dan and seeing his Supra and seeing his level of quality builds, I decided that it was time to treat my 350Z with the love that it deserves. So about 2 weeks ago, I decided that we had to redo the whole entire car.
Before showing you what's in the garage, the whole exterior of my car is literally sitting right here. And when it's done, it will finally be a proper 350Z Rocket Bunny. So this is something very, very cool that I want to show you guys that I haven't seen anybody do yet. Here are my rear over fenders. They were pretty much one piece from Crown Carbon Crafting 50 mil over fender that was molded and just fit over the rear panel. And it wasn't a rear Rocket Bunny. But because we cut so much of the metal out, I wasn't able to use this thin piece of Rocket Bunny because it had nothing to mount to. So I got a 15 mil over fender from Crown Carbon Crafting. Rad Industries have done is they mounted the Rocket Bunny fenders on top of those fenders to put on the back.
So it's gonna be like a one of one custom design that we're gonna be able to remake, and it will finally be full Rocket Bunny. I didn't want to wrap the car again because I feel like it's just not a full send, and I really wanted a full send. So we're painting the car, interior and exterior. I'm not telling you what color quite yet, but I will tell you, you guys are always telling me, stop playing it so safe with colors, don't do white, go something lighter, don't do black. So I will say this, I promise you, the next color, the color that we're painting in 350Z, will satisfy you guys 100%, I promise that. Now enough of me hyping it up, let me go show you what the current state of the 350 is.
Dan has made my car no longer a car anymore. This is like 2 days of work. Dan had like 4 or 5 people on it and everything is gone. I didn't even realize you were pulling the motor. And I saw under Snap or your IG story, I was like, what? When you posted the O Doctor, I was like, Dan doesn't say O Doctor. And then I looked at it and I was like, wait, that's my car. I loved it. So the motor is pulled, everything on the bay is gone, everything is off, the interior is gutted, and the rear end is completely naked. We are going 100%. I wanna make this car amazing. I know some people will be like, oh, well, you're gonna be scared to drive it. That's not the case. The car is meant to be driven. It's never scared me before, so I promise you it's not gonna scare me now. I'm not gonna tell you the color theme of the car, but the whole entire rear tubed end is gonna get painted the same color as the interior. Our door cards are gonna be painted, our bay is gonna be painted, and then the whole exterior of the car is gonna be painted. Even the front, so no more rusty metal. That's all gonna be painted. I'm so excited. So Dan, give him a rundown of pretty much what's been done so far.
Peeled the vinyl off, some of the body panels that we're gonna get painted. Can't tell you guys what color, but it's gonna be different than white. Don't, hopefully that didn't give it away. We took all the panels off and then started like kind of like getting a plan of how we're gonna improve on certain areas, because TJ's plan here is to make it reliable, but also we want it to be more appealing when you open the hood, open the back, and like inside we're cleaning up some stuff. So we're just kind of giving everything a once over. As you can see, the motor is out. We kind of shave some things in the bay that'll clean it up, and then we have some ideas, but they're gonna be surprises. So
woo!
Can't tell you guys about how we're gonna make, you know, the theme in the engine bay. That's like our main thing here, is engine bay theme.
Yeah, that was one of the things that I asked Dan. I was like, when I open the hood, I want to just be like, I want it to look super clean. One of my favorite bays ever is Dan's FD Supra. So I was like, I don't have like the full crazy budget to go full crazy, but I was like,
Medium crazy
so for now.
Medium crazy engine bay. You'll see.
We were debating kind of changing up the rear setup, but just for budget wise, I'm not sure what we're gonna do yet, but we are making some slight modifications, changing up the fuel pump setups and the filters and stuff like that. But we have the surge tank from DW. So we have a lot of stuff from DW that we'll be redoing in the back. And now DW makes AN fittings and stuff. So I need to make a big order from DW and have it sent here to have all that stuff come in.
Be prepared for this to not be raw metal anymore.
That's one of my most excited things.
It's gonna be cool.
It's a painted car, no rust, no ugly metal. I guess interior wise, it's gonna stay the same.
Pretty much the same, but cleaned up paint. And then where we can add details, which people like details, we're adding details.
Like, I want details.
Details are the best.
I was like debating about trying to put in like something hidden on the roof or something. I don't know. It was like, I had that Just Send It sticker that you only see if you're in the car, which no one else really knows that. Or like that Chot sticker. Are you guys keeping that big ugly plate that Calvin welded into the car?
If you want us to take it out, we will take it out now at this time.
What would we do? Would you just like cut it out and then it's like make it smoother?
One that's like a little less thick, I think. A little less industrial.
When Calvin was learning to weld, I let him weld in like a little like shift boot cover. And it was like the thickest, largest piece of metal. It's all we had. And Calvin was so proud of it. But every time someone sees it, they're like, do you want us to fix that? But I'm kind of like, it's kind of a little meme. It's a memory of Calvin learning to weld that I've always kept. But maybe it's time to get rid of this big, ugly thing. I think when it's all painted, it won't look as ugly. But I might have Dan clean it up and make it look a little bit more pretty.
Okay. We could do that.
Oh, I meant to ask that too. The floors?
Yeah.
Can we, or I think I saw on your Supra, you have like... So there's a lot going down with the car. I'm really excited about it. I haven't talked about this at all, and I kind of want to just like throw it at you guys and be like, bam, get ready for it. Full send, it's coming. Cause I know it's overdue. So I wanted to make a little update video going over everything. I didn't tell you that much, but I think I told you guys just enough to keep you on the edge of your seat. It will make all of you very proud, make you guys very, very happy. The timeline for this is honestly like a month or so. It's gonna take about a week and a half in paint, and then when it gets back in paint, they have to redo everything. That's one of the biggest things that I'm really excited about. For one, I didn't want to do a month's worth of vlogs of like cutting and doing the same small thing and uploading that every day for one reason. And for two, my quality of work is not even on the same blip as what Rad Industries is able to do. And for something that like my life is in the hands of the car and the quality of work, not that I don't trust myself, but this is something that I want to be done 10 out of 10. And I know that, like, I can honestly say that I will not be able to do near the same level of work as this shop is, obviously. So I wanted to have them redo it once over and just give me the car that I dream of on the track. So huge shout out to Ride Industries. I know he's documenting a lot of the videos of them like taking things apart and like welding stuff. And if you guys are into that and you want to see the R&D of everything, I'll link Ride Industries down below. They have a YouTube channel, which some of you guys probably aren't familiar of, but they'll be documenting all that stuff. So if you want to catch behind the scenes, be sure to check them out. And I'm feeling old.